Everything's broken! Millions of websites using Google Fonts experience right now what happens when a font gets updated and suddenly things shift. Specifically, it's about the typeface Inter that got replaced by a newer version recently. So in this video, I will tell you what happened, how you can fix it for your website and in Figma as well, and what you should be aware of to prevent these kinds of problems in the future. So welcome to Fix My Type. In my latest video, I talked about the changes that came with the update to version 4 of the popular typeface Inter. Along with significant improvements like optical sizing, Inter 4.0 also changed its flavor quite a bit by replacing the slanted italics with true italics. So I assumed that it would not simply be replaced by Google Fonts, because this might result in text reflow at best and in a loss of functionality at worst. But I was wrong. It happened. So if you made use of the slant axis, you won't be able to access it anymore in the newer version, and you most likely will see a different spacing for smaller sizes. And larger sizes, of course. To learn more about these changes, watch my video linked in the description. Now, what happened to millions of websites that use Google Fonts to host Inter will happen in your Figma projects as well, if it has not already when you're watching this video. There you will see shifts in your UI or web design too. The question now is, what can you do about it? There are two options. Update your design and embrace the changes. Yay, we love changes! Yeah, well, there are quite some few improvements, and when it comes to setting text in larger sizes, it looks better. See them in my previous video. The other version, or the other option, is to go back to the older version and self-host the fonts. This also brings plenty of advantages when it comes to performance and GDPR compliance, which is always awesome, isn't it? So if you want to learn how to do it, there is a great video by Kevin Powell that will show you step by step. Find the link to version 3 of Inter and to Kevin's video in the description as well. If Inter has already been updated in Figma and you want the previous version, you need to install it locally. So download it and then install it. This way it will override the Google fonts available in Figma and access the local fonts. I tested this with another Google font that I installed locally, but note that everyone else who works on this project has to do the same, or otherwise they will see the current version of it and this might conflict in the design step. Now, what can we learn from this? Basically, not to rely on Google Fonts for consistency. If you want that, self-host your fonts. Fonts are software, so of course they can and should be updated when things change or get improved. But sometimes these changes or improvements are too much, or we considered our design around other things. So in these cases, it's really important to be thoughtful about your type choices and maybe stick to them. If you came here because you watched the Inter 4.0 review, thanks a lot for the views, comments and likes. This really was a viral moment for me after 4 years of doing YouTube videos, so I guess I'm famous now. So if you're into it already, then enjoy this video here next, and
du musst hello, also machst du. Hello and welcome to
Pimp My Type.
Okay. Du machst das immer so komisch.